Hi, welcome to the White Noise Studio. I'm Marlon. Adding bass and extending low end with a drain pipe. That is what this episode is about. If you ever have hit a pipe like this, then you know it produces a sound. Due to its diameter and length, this one produces a low note, a low E around 84 Hz to be exact. This is something you can use in a very useful way in a recording and in a mix. Let's go to the live room and I will show you a setup I sometimes use for this type of recording. I will use this drum setup for the examples of the sound through the pipe. The pipe will be used as an extension of the low end of this bass drum. And as you can see, I've placed the pipe pretty close to the front head of the bass drum. Whenever I play the bass drum, the sound will travel through the pipe and come out at the other end where I will record it with a microphone. In this case, it will be a Rode NT1. So what happens is I play the bass drum, sound goes through the pipe, the microphone picks it up and we'll record it inside Cubase. Let's go back to the control room and I will let you hear how it sounds. I've recorded a straight 4 on the floor groove to showcase how the tube can be used in a mix. Here is the drum groove without the tube. And here's the tube soloed. You can really hear its tube or pipe sound. And as you can see here in FabFilter Pro 3, it produces an E around 84 Hz. The harmonics give it its typical sound. There's also some snare drum bleed in there, as you can hear. To use the sound of the pipe as an extension, I will use a low pass to remove the harmonics and the snare drum bleed. And now we only have low end. Usually the area around 60 Hz is what's loved for bass drum low end. So what I do is this, I tune the drain pipe. By simply lowering the pitch of the tube, I get the low end I want. And now we have the low end around 60 Hz. But the cool thing is, you can do whatever you want. If you lower the pitch even more, you get in those really earth-shattering low end sub-bass frequencies. Like this, it's filling in all the low end, and this can easily be too much. That's why I usually do some additional stuff, like gating the recorded tube pipe. The trigger makes sure the opening and the closing of the gate is much more controllable, and it gives you a lot of flexibility of how much of the low end you want in a recording. You can even make the tube follow bass notes in a song. It's a trick which dance producers use a lot, and in a lot of bass heavy styles this happens too. Let me show you how to do that. Let me find the start of a measure. Here, I will make a cut. I will take 4 beats. 4 beats. 4 beats. 4 beats. Okay. This one is minus 12. The next one will make minus 5. This one will make minus 3. And back to minus 5. Okay. It will sound like this. It sounds really cheesy, but you get the idea. We used tuning of a tube in the end of 2019 year release by Dead Neanderthals called Mankind. This one. We replaced the entire bass drum with a tube. I will put a link in the description below so you can check it out. Another example of the use of a drain pipe is on a project I have with Frick Felipe called Megalomanja. It's on our second release called Megaira and the track Megaira. I use a tube to accentuate a tom-tom rhythm and it sounds like this. I will also put the link in the description below. And there's also a track by Kees Peerdeman where I used a drain pipe as an extension of a programmed kick drum. Only there I used a Auratone speaker to trigger the sound through that drain pipe. The link to that track will be in the description below, just as the other two. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye!